Yeah, and you know, the book is not autobiography, but it makes use of autobiographical material. And I've talked about the way in which that middle section is the section that comes closest to autobiography, and there are movements between the father and the son that are just transcribed. I mean, when my father found out I was gay, he said to me what the narrator's father says to him, which is, "You're not my son." And he kicked me out of the house when I was 14. And we didn't speak for a long time, and then we tried to have a rapprochement, and I have not spoken to him in more than a decade. You know, I think when you're a kid, you take the circumstances of your life for granted, and in some ways, you think that you deserve what has happened to you. And I think for a long time, I did carry around a feeling that sort of I had earned those words from my father. And then I became a high school teacher, and I started working with kids who were 14 years old, the age I was when my father kicked me out. And I realized that, oh, wait, actually, no. There's nothing a 14-year-old can do that warrants a parent saying that. You know, I wrote this book, I think, to a certain degree in order to, in order to explore that relationship between fathers and sons, and also to question certain ideas about the relationship between parents and children.